Hey everybody, and welcome back to another Darkfall video. So first, I just want to acknowledge the fact that we've reached over 10,000 subscribers. It's incredible to believe that there's so many of you guys actually enjoying these videos, and I just wanted to say thanks for showing your support. Thanks for sharing and commenting and everything you guys are doing. So it makes all the effort I put into these videos worth it. So thanks to you guys. So in this video, I just want to share with you the update for the text tool add-on version 1.2. And if you want to check out any of the previous videos, there'll be a link up here. Go ahead and click that. And there'll be a link in the description if you want to read a little bit more about it. But let's go ahead and take a look at it. If we just delete all these, we don't need them. If we press N and then go down to the text tool tab. So for those of you who've already seen this, you can see we now have the animation tab. So we'll take a look at this in a second. First, I just want to add some text as we normally would do. And then you can see we have this new option called the auto italic. So let's just add some normal text. Just add this in. Then I'm going to go to top view just to see this. And then if we just add text again, this time type italic. And then change this to auto italic. And then click OK. Now we can see we have this italic effect. Again, this would work for different font types, so let me just go and open a different font type. But essentially, just pick any kind of font that you want. Let's try this one. So again, it works with the different font types, but yeah, it gives you a quick option to change it to italic. And the other addition that we made is now this animations tab. And right now there's only one animation because I've got a whole bunch of different things I'm working on, and there'll be more animations added to this. And by the way, you guys have suggested improvements to this add-on, and I have noted them. You know, I've not forgot about them. It just takes time to do everything. I can't do everything all at once, but yeah, hopefully you guys understand that, and these improvements slowly but surely will be coming. But we see we have this typewriter slash scrolling text effect, and if you followed my channel for a while, you'll know I did a tutorial on how to do this within Blender just manually. So this is what we should be able to achieve, this scrolling text effect here. This is the starting example, but you can see through the video I explain how to sort of do all of this, which takes 5 minutes to do, which is quite long. It goes through, just shows you how to set up the scrolling text effect. Instead of that, I thought it'd be nice just to add an option here where if we select a text, any text that you want, then click this button, it'll bring up a dialog box. And as you can tell, I love dialog boxes. We've only got two options, the start frame and the duration. So we want it to start on frame one, and we want it to last for 25 frames. Again, if you want to change this, you can make it 50 frames or you can make it less. It's up to you. But by default, I'm just going to select this. And now we can see it's disappeared. But as we play through the timeline, we can see it appears as a scrolling text type animation. So we can see it's a little bit slow. If we go to the modifiers, we can actually change the modifier here. So what I'm going to do is just cut this in half, divide it by two. Then if we play it again, we can see it's much faster. You can play around with this, it's entirely up to you. So I'm just going to grab this, move it down, select the button again. So now for this second text, I only want this to begin when this has ended. So we know the first one ends at 12, so we can start this at 12. And the duration is going to be 12. So click OK. Go back to the first frame, play through. See, we have this. So hopefully as we move forward, we'll add some more animations to this. If you guys have any suggestions, again, make sure you leave in the comments. Hopefully you'll find this helpful. If you do, be sure to hit that like button. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.